And a good morning at 4:45. A little bit of haze and fog around the region. Checking visibility, just a half a mile in Wahpeton, 1 mile in some haze around the Fargo-Moorhead area. And elsewhere, Harvey has 7 miles, 3 in Langdon, 1/4 mile visibility up in the Hallock area. And Roseau also 3/4 mile, Bedette. Near Red Lake, Waskish there in the northeast corner of Upper Red Lake, 2.5 miles visibility, 1/4 mile visibility around Bemidji, and 3 in Fauston. So yesterday afternoon, evening's rain shower activity dropping about 1/4 to 1/2 inch of rain. It's now working its way with a clear sky, nearly calm conditions. We have fog, and that's a lot better than flooding, which is what's going on from today. We have thunderstorms working their way out of Iowa across northern Illinois, southern Wisconsin. As the day progresses, the thunderstorm potential will be greatest northeast Kansas through the southern part of the Corn Belt, all the way out to Washington, D.C., and out in the Black Hills. Our hour-by-hour forecast. No rain this morning. Rain this afternoon? Possible. Just some isolated pop-up showers and maybe a pop-up thunder shower anywhere, any place. Late afternoon, the heat of the day evaporating the topsoil moisture. Things like that just happen. And then overnight tonight, another 50s for overnight lows, mid to upper 50s, and on the way to the upper 70s to low 80s again tomorrow with some isolated pop-up afternoon showers or thunderstorms. Again, Southern Valley, west central Minnesota is where those could happen, but they could happen up north too. Now on Friday night into early Saturday, we'll have a little front that'll come through. This could generate easily some scattered showers and thunderstorms with overnight lows in the mid-60s to near 70. On the through the day on Saturday, the potential exists for some higher likelihood of scattered showers, thunderstorms, especially across Minnesota. All right. Radar showing nothing up there around Kenora. Some scattered. That looks like another one of those temperature inversions as the radar wave gets bent. It's a long ways away from any radar sight, and that does happen. This, though, is real. For the second morning in a row, the nearly stationary northern branch of the jet stream steering storms into the southern Black Hills. And in its wake, look at those training thunderstorms. A flash flood watch out there in eastern parts of Wyoming. Quiet across Nebraska. But the big storms of overnight from Des Moines down to Quincy and St. Louis, from Davenport, Peoria, through Champaign, Urbana, Chicago, into central Illinois, in Indiana, near Indianapolis, all of that will sink southward into abundant humidity, and we'll set off some strong storms there. There's a look at some of the big storms there in North Carolina and South Carolina. And upstream from us, there's a fair amount of instability. Again, right along and underneath the jet stream that'll be waving its way through us. So every day, chance of afternoon showers and thunderstorms. Corn growing degree days, racking them up nicely. A lot of sunshine, not too hot. Perfect growing weather. The air is calm, so we do have some fog issues out there this morning. And the temperatures are in the mid to upper 50s for the most part. So for the next few days, about 80, 83, 84, warm, pleasant. An unsettled weekend coming with that front coming through on Saturday. And again, Sunday, chance of a shower or thunderstorm. And after that, Monday, Tuesday, a lot of heat. And then a cold front slams in, generating some storms. All right, time is 4:48. Where are the markets at this morning? Randy Martinson will give us his take on markets right after the break.